Do you want to play a fun video game? Well, why not try Titanfall 2? Really? There are a lot of FPSs on this list, and I'm generally not much of a fan of the genre, so it's difficult for me to convey why these are all interesting, distinct games that are all worthy of your attention. Titanfall 2 is riding on the shoulders of the big budget, brief war campaign, time-sync multiplayer, FPS cliché, and at a glance you'd think it was just another one of those. It's even developed by ex-Infinity Ward staff, the people who made you cynical about the genre, thanks to the endless stream of annual Call of Duty titles that they started. They're tired of it too, so they made a fun game. A game where your friends with a big robot and slide on your knees while shooting baddies. Titanfall 2 isn't Call of Duty or Battlefield or even Halo. It's Vanquish and Portal. It's creative, surprising, exciting and silly. What a nice surprise. Titanfall 2's campaign is probably the most varied and impressive and innovative I've seen in a first-person game since Portal 2. Every section gives you something new to try and it's usually pretty fucking mental. This is a game where you jump from wall to wall over pits of fire and catch missiles in mid-air before chucking them back at the enemy. It's a laugh! Everything's done very slickly and no level-long gimmick outstays as well can detract from the core shooting gameplay. This is first and foremost a punchy, speedy FPS, and the game isn't so much in love with its set pieces to undermine your freedom in combat. It pays itself by routinely giving you and taking away gadgets and weapons. It means you're always excited to see how the next section will pan out. Respawn have done a great job on this. Titanfall 2 is a shooter with proper level design. It's not a series of gritty environments. It's suspended platforms and level-long gimmicks that make you do wee impressed noises. There's thought and care behind how this game is paced, and not just in a dramatic sense. You're learning while you experiment, and it never feels like you're in a tutorial. You're having a big laugh, and the set pieces punctuate your fun with cool nonsense and big payoffs. Your friendship with the big robot, BT, is cartoonish, but you're in on the silliness and grinning with it. If I was 10, I'd take it seriously and love it. I'm 29, and it's all just a big laugh to me, and I think I love it just as much. But Titanfall 1 was a multiplayer-only game. Single-player campaigns are not really the main feature of this IP. Titanfall is an online shooter, and it's a terrific one. All the moves you learn through the campaign are intrinsic parts of the multiplayer. You can climb up buildings and pilot mechs and slide on your knees while firing shotguns. The maps are huge and fully wee cubbyholes and big towers, and the fights make good use of them. Climbing on an enemy mech to steal a battery is a good trick, and giving it to an ally mech to boost their health makes it even more fun. There's a great deal of customization options to unlock, and the ex-Infinity Ward people know how to craft an addictive online mode. But again, it's the single player that I was really impressed by. I have too many options with online shooters these days, and even a really good one can struggle to draw me in for an extended period. That campaign is the sales point as far as I'm concerned. It's punchy, big, loud, silly and innovative, and I'm really happy with that. Titanfall 2 exists in an odd position within the B tier of the AAA franchises, but it's got far more to shout about than any of the annual bores. This is like a game designed by a wee boy, and wee boys know what's fun. I hope they know about Titanfall 2. They'd love it. You'll love it. It's what you want from a video game. Mental daft shit that could never happen in real life, but it's a joy to be a part of. I wouldn't say Titanfall 2 is a sleeper hit or underrated, but it's a game that I was unlikely to pick up, and I'm really glad I did. Please consider this one.